ball thrown into court. Jana Sherban to serve first. And the 24-year-old will get us underway. A big test of Yuri Manichev's new-look Russian team. They were the European champions last year. Remember, defeated Germany in the final. Went to the Grand Champions Cup with a very young team, which failed to really achieve much. Camilla break behind that one. Turned over on two by Danny Lintz. Couldn't really do very much else. Chance here for Malik straight away. Doesn't put it away. Kosyanenko sets to the far side and hit off the block. And the opening point goes the way of the Russians, Yulia Kuchikova. Another deep serve. Natalia didn't like that one too much. Gets a bump set from Camilla Brake back to her and puts away an exquisite spike cross court. Well, both of the players we picked as the most important for both teams come up with the opening 2 points of this one. Natalia to serve. The best of passes, and Kosyanenko under pressure. Natalia serve has borne fruit throughout this tournament so far. And an ace serve. Sherban unable to play it into her setter, Kosyanenko. Good change up again, Kuchikova. Through and gets the touch. Unable to get across to it, so ball now goes into the hands of Irina Zarezhko. And that's a foul serve from Zarezhko. He's been erratic from the service line so far in the tournament. Good takedown. Kosyanenko with a shallow set, neatly put away by Shlikovaya. Interesting opening few salvos from both teams. Malik, dipping serve, dealt with by Natalia Adonetsia. Didn't get as much power on that. Malova, reverse bump set, and cleverly played through the defences by Kuchikova. Levels things once again at four apiece. Malik, deep serve. Natalia gets it into Danny Lintz. Adonetsia again doesn't put it away. Kosyanenko straight back into Shlikovaya. Tandara serve, Malova. Malik unable to put it away from the back line. Natalia gets it forward to Tandara again. And off the ceiling from Shlikovaya. So exchanges of couplets. Malova. Important touch there from Shlikovaya, but the chance is still here for Gabby. Malik keeps it alive from the back line, just turned in. Tandara and Adonetsia's reflexes let her down there. Great touch across to Gabby, and she hits through the block. Great block. The Brazilians accelerate themselves into the first technical timeout, and they have a 3-point lead. 8-5. Plenty of questions that need to be answered by Yuri Maryachev and his Russian team. Gabby serves. Maliba, not the greatest of passes, but they look as though they got away with it. Beautifully guided home by Sheraban. Shlikovaya whips the serve in. Lovely touch from Natalia. Gets back to make the spike, but she's put too much on that. Shlikovaya again. Off the top of the net. Natalia just keeps it alive. Tandara turns it in towards Russian territory. Malik. Tandara underneath it. Natalia, well blocked. Danny Lins goes to Natalia again. No touch. Again. 3 points in a row for the Russians. 8 points apiece. Shlikovaya deep in on Natalia. This time Gabby. Camilla Brait will keep that in play. Kosyanenko to Malik. Brilliantly done. Four points in a row now for the Russians, and they lead 9-8. Natalia, Gabby. Tandara gets a touch on the way through. Kosyanenko can set this one. Just touched over. Camilla Brait flies in. Danny Lin sets again. And Edenetsia gets her first point of the match. And the Brazilians back on level terms. Edenetsia at the top of the net. Kosyanenko to Malik. Down the line. Kosyanenko again on serve. Good serve, one taken down by Natalia. He reacted really well to that. No touch. And Carroll puts it long. It's another unforced error. Clearly no touch and clearly long. Di Roberto, he looks concerned. Natalia, Camilla Brake sends it forward towards Natalia. The Russian block gets in the way. Now they lead 12-9. Timeout taken by Brazil.
Nessa na passagem duas não é de cacete. Fecha um pouquinho a mão para tocar nessa bola, que essa bola é lisa, para não deixar escapar. Galera, não são elas, nós aqui não estamos pensando na porra do jogo. Sai o passe rápido. A 7 recebe, a gente tinha acabado de falar o negócio da largada dela, não pode cair. Vai, bora.
Masayoshi Manabe. Sitting up in the stands, taking this one in. And also preparing his players for their encounter this evening. And they will take on the Dominican Republic. Natalia takes down from the serve, and Tandara does manage to get it to land in. An important spike there from Tandara. Danny Lintz on serve. Sherman, guided well by Kosyanenko into the path of Zarashko. Sherman. Serve taken down by Natalia again, and Tandara coming in from the opposite side this time. Natalia, deep serve taken down by Sherevan. Kosyanenko to Malik. And one of the changes that's just come into effect. Anastasia Bavkina to serve straight away. Natalia manages to dig out well. Gabby doesn't get it through Kosyanenko. Bump set. Oh, fantastic block from the Brazilians. Half chance for Kuchikova. Evenly balanced set. Incredible takedown from Kosyanenko. Came to nout. Carol serve. Kuchikova. Cleverly done, just rolling it over the top of the defence. Russians have turned this round well. Natalia Malik. Set to Tandara. Had an impressive first set. Serves taken down by Kuchikova. Reverse set. Brazilians keep it alive. Camila Breit to Natalia. Off the top of that block. Sherebam was there. Kosyanenko sets it across to Kuchikova. Tandara gets it back into Camila Breit again. Turned over by Gabby this time. Kuchikova does get a touch. And they arrive at the second technical, with the Russians having forged into a 3-point lead. It's 16-13.
Еще, Юля, смотрите, даже пока штрафуете, нету. Если можно, можно в котел тебя обмануть. Можно. Даже если сейчас на игрок, когда нападали, нет никого. Что за ситуация, посмотрите.
Лети,
все нормально, руки сюда бросай. Она все так стык, они и бьют все время. Твоя задача стык закрыть. Хорошо?
Yuri Malachev animated in that technical timeout. Serve from Kuchikova. Gabby's underneath it. Dani Linz struggles to get across and keep it alive, but Gabriela, after a poor pass, makes up for it with a fantastic spike. Frustration for Yuri Malachev that his block didn't get more out of that. Gabriela serve into Kuchikova. Malik through the middle. Hasn't really missed so far today. Zalezhko returns in place of Anastasia Babkina. The rotation bringing the Russian middle blocker straight back in to the blocking position. That extra height offered now to the Russian team. Zhereshko standing 1.96 meters tall. Shliakovaya, good dipping serve in on Natalia. Dani Linz sets back to Natalia. And although it wasn't the cleanest of connections, enough for the point. And 11 points in a row of side-out volleyball. Adonetsia. Kosianenko to Malik. Fantastic angle. Tipped in, Natalia. Set again, Tandara. Kosianenko couldn't get across to it. 13 points now. It's 18-16 to Russia. Dani Linz serve. Malova. Kosianenko. Block is wide. Well, just for a second there. A panicked look on Zhereshko's face. Thought that the block had come off for the Brazilians, but wide of the court. Yana Shiriban. Good deep pushed in on Natalia again. Tandara touches over. Attempt to keep it alive from Zhereshko, actually dragged it away from Kosianenko. Natalia serve again. Dug out by Sherban. Malik comes in. Zhereshko underneath it. Kosianenko sends it across. Kuchikova doesn't put it away. Here's a chance then for the Brazilians. Tandara, and that block is wide. 19 points to 18. Yuri Malachev could think about taking a timeout, and does.
Mm-hmm.
Нам надо чуть пошире увести, чуть-чуть пошире туда. И сделать то, что это съемчик там сзади. Повнимательнее, давай, все. Вот прием надо начать, давай.
Давай, давай, приди.
Crowd on the edge of their seats here. It is a fraught first set. Can Natalia bring it all square once again? She can, but an ace. 3 points in a row now for the Brazilians. Means a change. Katarina Chernova. So a double libero approach here being adopted by the Russians. Chernova usually plays as a libero. Manova was there and they just get away with it. Zorezhko with the vital touch to keep them a point in front, which at this stage is incredibly important. Zorezhko to serve. Camilla Breit underneath it, Danny Lins. Carroll can't keep it alive. The Russians have two in a row. Now is this where Zeroberto takes his second timeout because his team are 2 points behind and time is running out in this set. Shlekovaya with the kill. Shlekovaya dips it in long. Lins across to Tandara and they marshal her this time. And Shlekovaya makes the block to make it 22-19. 3 points immediately after the Brazilians had put 3 points together. Timeout taken by Zeroberto as his side see this opening set slipping away from their grasp after fighting so hard to come back into it.
Faz ela correr. Se não fizer ela correr, ela vai parada, ela vai matar. Ou então, chutada para ficar mais seguro, porque a bola sobreposta vai ser melhor. Tem que fazer essa mulher do meio correr. Essa mais do que a outra. Essa bloqueia é melhor.
Puxa, puxa,
puxa.
Vamos lá, Daniel. Vamos lá. Vamos lá. Vamos lá. Having to use up his second team timeout here after Tandara was brilliantly blocked by Shlekovaya. 22-19 the score. Russia with a really good chance here of taking the opening set off Brazil. Breit up to Dani Lins. Gabby is the target and she goes down the line. A nod from Yuri Marachev that this had landed in. Double change. Andrea coming on. Good serve. Meant that Malik didn't have many options there. They're going to struggle to keep that alive. Fine work from the Brazilians. So Russia take their next time out. They lead by just one now. Thank you. barrel serve. Goes along. Chanova manages to keep it alive. Fantastic spike from Kuchikova under pressure. Danilin's complaining because they felt it was a double touch from Chernova to keep it alive. Not given. Zeroberto felt it should have been given as well. As it is, the Russians find themselves now with Malik with the ball in hand, leading 23-21. Malik serve. Natalia takes down. Danilin sets to Tandara. And there was a touch on the way through. Well, Blinken, you might miss it. No complaints, though, from the Russians. Monique brought on, and Fabiola joining her. From Fabiola, taken down. Kosyanenko sent it back to Kuchikova, and that goes wide, bringing up two set points for the Russians. Kuchikova now serves. Zeroberto faces the possibility of a long afternoon and evening here in Montreux. For a second day in a row, Kuchikova pushes the serve wide, so not forcing the Brazilians to play, but a side out now required by the Russians. Gabby to serve. Off the top of the net. Back into play, there were plenty of touches on the net. Well, Kosyanenko looks across to the near side referee, just questioning what on earth the decision making here was. A clear touch of the net on the way up. Referee, I reckon he didn't see it. Malik, and she's blocked, and the Brazilians now have set point. Gabriela again, first set point for the Brazilians, taken down by Kuchikova, and then Malik gets her spike away, back to 25 all. Nikovaya with the serve, dipped in on Natalia. Fabiola sets back to Natalia, a Russian block, got across to it, can't deflect it down though. Set point number two. There'll definitely be some regret at the moment on the Kuchikova serve. Adnetia serves in on Kochakova. It's a wide angle from Chaban, but she manages to make the most of it.
Et le public pour les encourages, quel spectacle!
26-all. And as the stadium announcer points out, the fans really are being treated here. Kosyanenko serve, Natalia in at Dani Lintz again for the return. Kept alive by Malova. Chaban guides it wide. Another simple waste. Set point number three for Brazil. Dani Lintz and Tandara return for Fabiola. And Monique. Dani Lintz to serve. Kochakova into Kosyanenko and Malik off the opposite side. Kept alive by Dani Lintz. Break and bump set for this to Natalia. Hit through. Kosyanenko, Malova, bump set now to Chaban. And she gets it blocked wide. A third set point saved by Russia. And back to 27 all. Three touches, the Russians. Go ahead. 28 points to 27. Set point number three for the Russians now. Chaban. So taken down by Natalia. Dani Lintz sets across to Tandara. Off the block of Malik. And it is 28 points apiece. Russian side out though gives them the next chance. It's Natalia on serve. It was her serve that managed to drag Brazil back right at the tail end of this set. Taken down by Chaban. Kosyanenko with plenty of options. One of them's Kochakova. Kochakova's there. Kosyanenko again back to Kochakova. Bump set towards Malik. And she pushes through. And touches the net on the way. Fingers just touching the top of the net. It's another controversial call involving the net. And it's the Brazilians who have the point. Set point number four for Brazil. Great serve, in it Chaban. Set to Malik. Dismissive. 29 apiece now. Well, it's easily the longest set of this Montreux Volley Masters in 2014. Dani Lintz sets to Tandara. Brazilians have a fifth set point. Carol on serve. Well, taken down. Kosianenko sits it across to Kuchikova. Back to 30 points apiece now. Malik on serve, Natalia, Danielins, Gabriella, no touch on the way through. There is a touch on the way through. Well, Yuri Marichev looked unconvinced by this, but feels that not much is going for them at the moment. Just the slightest of touches there off Kosianenko. Set point number 6 for Brazil. Kosianenko, Malik, plenty to do, kept alive by Tandara, and off the antenna, so back to 31s. Celoberto clutches his scalp. Kuchikova, Natalia again with a great pass. Gabriella was there, Sherabans underneath it. Kuchikova. And there is a touch. Set point number 4 for the Russians. Kuchikova. Daniel Linz manages to get it back to Tandara, turned it in. Linz is there again. Camilla Brake with the bump set across to Gabriella. Wrong puts the Russian defence. 32 apiece. No less than 10 set points so far. 6 for the Brazilians, 4 for the Russians, none converted. An epic first set. Kuchikova. It has to be a bump set from Kosianova and Sherabans. Set point 5 for the Russian team. Serve from Shliakovaya. Natalia, Danielins gets the return to Natalia. Half blocked here. Calls needed. Shliakovaya underneath it. Kosianenko and Sherabans. Fantastic block from Adonetsia and Natalia. Half a chance there for the Brazilians. Shutting the door on the Russians there. Adonetsia to serve at 33s. Kosianenko across to Sherabans. She manages to hit through the block again. To give the Russians their 6th set point chance. It's as many as the Brazilians have had in this set. Natalia. Set back to Tandara, kept alive by Maliba. Here's the chance, Sherabans. Kept alive again, Natalia through the middle, Maliba. Tandara's underneath it, Dani Linz. She touches the net, and Russia have the set. 35 points to 33, they take it. 12 set point chances between them. It's on their 6th set point chance that the Russians convert. 35-33, a thrilling opening set here. If the rest of the match lives up to that one, we are in for an absolute stonker of a performance from both teams. Brazil trail by a set to 0. They came back from 2-1 down against China yesterday. They've yet to lose the opening set in the tournament, though. They've lost the opening set against the Russians here. How will they respond? We will find out in set number 2.
día, todo no sé por qué, algo no me tira. ¿Será que los rompo ahí en la tarima? ¿Será que los rompo ahí en la tarima? Te digo,
there are the stats from that first set. 26 attacks to 18 in the Russians' favour. Both much of a muchness in errors. 7 blocks from the Brazilians to 3 from the Russians. And in the end, just too much. The Russians were unrelenting in their pressure towards the end. Quite fantastic. Never gave up and were rewarded for it. Out for set number 2. Another test for the Brazilians. One I'm sure they will be capable of responding to. Ball in hand, ready to go. Serves in, Shalaban underneath it. Kosyanenko goes short, and Zhereshko gets the opening point under the Russian belts. Natalia, and she didn't get a touch on the way through. Foul serve. From Natalia. Good reception. Slickly done. Shlikovaya. Something a bit flat about the Brazilian performance all of a sudden. Malik serve. Great underneath it. Danny Lintz, so much time to get it to Gabby. And in spite of the best endeavours of Shalaban there, she can't control it. Do you remember the scenario here? If the Russians win, and win 3-0 or 3-1 against Switzerland. They will have 6 points out of the reach of Natalia. At present, Brazil are on 5 points. Should Russia win 3-0 or 3-1 here and put them on to 3 points? Two wins would be 6, and it would mean the Brazilians would not be through to the semi-finals. Malova with a brilliant effort, but again, just not good enough. I know we're getting ahead of ourselves, but should Russia take set number 2, and a certain amount of panic will set in for the Brazilians. Tandara, a serve. No panic as of yet, as they get back to 4-all. Decent serve, well taken down. Kosyanenko. Well, Shliakovaya was red that time. It's 3 points in a row for the Brazilians. They lead 5-4. Pandara. So the ban. Lucky deflection. Camilla Brake gets it to Tandara though. Kuchikova gets it across to Malik. Danny Lintz dives in. Brake with the set down the line, and Gabby just guides it along. They go into a 6-4 lead. Good run this on the Tandara serve. Kuchikova. Malik. And in front of the attack line. 7-4. 5 points in a row. Kuchikova does well. Sherban. Malova underneath it. Kuchikova goes back to Sherban. We're lining up for the Brazilians. And Gabby tries to guide that down the line. Malik could still keep this in play, and does, but the Brazilians in control. Danny Lintz back to Gabby. Brilliant from Malova to keep it alive. Lintz, as the Brazilians look to kill it for a third time. Delicacy works a treat. They come in at the first technical. Remember, they were down 4-2, Brazil. They come in at the first technical, up 8-4.
Pour le Brésil.
Well, brilliant attempt here by the Russians to stay alive. Brute force wasn't doing the job, Malova keeping it alive there. But in the end, Gabby just guiding it over the top. 6 points in a row. The Brazilians continue to pepper Kuchikova. Sherban manages to bring it to an end. But they trail 5-8. Slikovar. Gabby underneath that one. Danny Lintz kept it flat. Edinetsia. Takes the point. Gabriela. Celeban. Kachakova. Malik. Oh, she's been so well marked in this set, and yet she still manages to get it through. Brings Kosyanenko to the line. Natalia, one of her weaker returns. Malova. Kuchikova, Malik, lands in. Better from Natalia. Danny Lintz gets the return back to her and she hits off the block. Venezia. Through from the back line, Kuchikova gets the touch on the way through. It's a tense moment here. Carol, the player who saw that just glance off her hand. Jana Sherban. Again, Natalia Lintz back to Natalia. This time the block stands firm for the Russians. And since that first technical timeout, they've had two clusters of two to bring themselves back within one. Zelezhko with the vital touch on that last one. Sherban serving at Natalia again. Lintz sets and off the top, kept alive by Malova. Kuchikova could dig out from Gabby. Pandara goes cross court. Kuchikova, bump set. And Kuchikova, it was a good chance. She failed to make any contact. Brazilian's getting some real luck there. Fantastic effort there from Malova. Kuchikova had to find contact and failed to do so. Russians with Zelezhko. Side out to bring it back to 10-11. Pandara, it's wide and there's no touch, and we are all square. Four up at the opening technical timeout. Zeleberto will be rather disappointed with the way things have just gone. Danny Lintz, and a miss from Carroll. Extraordinary, you just never see the Brazilians doing something like that. They are really feeling the pressure here. Now 12-11 to Russia. And we're still on Zelezhko's serve. Pushed in, just too deep. So 12 points apiece. Malik kept alive, break, sets it across to Gabby, who tries to slide it down the line. Malibu was there. Malik again hits off the block this time.
Elena Lovic pour la place de numéro 17, Natalia Malik.
Changes made. Malik off. Novik into the fray. It's a great serve. There's a chance for the Russians. That's over that far side. Kuchikova. Camilla Brake can't get a hand on that. And Russia move ahead by two. Timeout taken by Brazil.
Chamar a atenção da outra um pouquinho mais no jogo. Tá muito passivo e muito desfilando, caralho. Porra, elas estão querendo matar a gente tá jogando devagar. Vamos pra porrada, não é o problema só. Bola tá alta, é outra postura de defesa, Camila. Ela vai dar reto, tá totalmente, tá deixando o lado esquerdo. A postura defensiva é diferente.
Incredible spiking power there from Kuchikova, and well, it's very, very rare that you see Yuri Maryachev smile. Natalia underneath it, Dani Lenz gets it across to Gabby. Fantastic block from the Russians. They increase their advantage. An end to that run for the Russians. 3 points it was worth, though. 13-15. Serve comes from Carroll. 13-15. It's long, and so we go into the second technical timeout with the Russians leading by three. Now, in the opening set, they had exactly the same lead. They went on to win it, of course, in that epic conclusion, 35-33. Are we in for another epic? We will have to wait and see, but it is the Russians who lead at the second technical.
Подачу, если есть возможность, давайте, 12 номера. У нее постоянно сейчас видит прием. Десятка доводит, 12 все сбивает. Все, подачу 12 номера. Запомнили, да?
Да,
все,
давай.
Давай.
The Swiss team are in here to watch their opponents for tomorrow, the Russians. Serve taken down by Natalia. Camilla Brake has to Keeping the bump set. Malik keeps it alive, jumping from the back line, because... Oh, that's an unbelievable slice of luck there, really, as it takes a deflection on the way through from Kuchikova's spike. Russians won't mind. 17-13 now. Kuchikova on serve again. Natalia Danilins to Gabby. Finally, the Brazilians bring an end to that run. You feel the Russians have done some serious damage there. The question is, can they sustain it? Their advantage, 3 points. Tandara to serve. Tandara had a great run on serve right at the beginning of the set. 5 points on it. Kuchikova underneath that one. Set back to Malik. Tandara can keep this alive, but Gabby won't be able to do anything but just bump it over the net. Shliakovaya was there, set to the far side for Shodovan. Great dig from Gabby to keep it alive once more for the Brazilians, and then gets the spike in herself. Malava's underneath that one. Malik cross-court for Tandara to keep out. Dani Lins to Gabby, hits through the block. Massive point for the Brazilians. Really, really important point. Russians threw everything at them. And Tandara continued this run on serve. That's going to go long from Tandara. Shliakovaya delighted as she sees it sail over their baseline, 18-15. And Shliakovaya to serve. Zhurashko back on. Kuchikova still looking to do the damage off the flanks. Good serve. Natalia turned over on two by Dani Lins. Needed to be. Gabby serve. Ace serve. Well, looked as though it was going long. And then just dipped in at the last minute. Timeout taken by Russia. Gabriella again, 1 point in it. Taken down by Shodovan. Malik managed to just get that one through the block. Kozienenko on serve. Natalia beautifully into Dani Lins and Anetsia. Brazilian managed to hold in there. Had Anetsia serve Shodovan. No one reacted. Zenoberto claps his hands, looks at Carroll, looks at Dani Lins. Can't believe that they didn't seize on that opportunity that was handed to them. Not a great reception from the Russians. Desperate times and measures used by Kosianenko to guide it up into the path of Zorajko. She just reached for it, and it was just enough. Sheliban serving then at 2018. Natalia gets the return. Plenty of power on that. Malova with a brilliant takedown. Malik. They get the block in place. Once again, the Russian libero's outstanding efforts not rewarded. Natalia with a vital block. Dani Lintz on serve. Russians looking to side out. Kosianenko with a touch from Malik. Change to be made by the Russians. Anastasia Babikina comes on to replace Irina Zorajko. What can Babikina do from the service line? Babikina. Break underneath it. Dani Lintz knows she has Natalia out on one side. Break kept an eye on the line there. Tantara from the other side. This could be kept alive. It's an awkward angle. Great. Dani Lintz sets again for Tantara. The block's good. Malik with the vital touch. Surely a Brazilian timeout now. They're down 22-19. So Roberto hasn't moved. He will take his second timeout. They were down by the same margin in the first set. They very nearly took that first set, remember? They had six set point chances, none converted. Here they are down 22-19 once again.
Claro, que eu não estou entendendo é que nós não estamos concentrando quando a bola está do lado de lá. Se ela estourar o corredor, Nath, a número 17, no simples, não é problema seu. Mas na diagonal é. Cada uma tem uma característica lá, moçada. O que, que eu falei, negócio da bola? No simples, ela vai jogar pra onde? Oh, então vamos pensar.
Vai, galera, vai. Defesa, Gabi. Defesa,
dois. Brilliant effort on the angle from Kuchikova to get it back into play, and then Malik rising to block the Tandara spike. Means that Babikina serves again. Gabriela, Dani Lintz across to Tandara. The Russian block stands firm. And this time, they extend their lead to 23-19. Zeroberto is looking down the barrel here. His team look as though they are going to have to come back from a two sets deficit. Monique onto the court in place of Tandara. Babikina, break underneath it. Dani Lintz sets back to Natalia. No touch. And it is five set points to the Russians. Camilla break. Dani Lintz. Carol makes it. Now they need to win 4 points at least on serve. Natalia, one side out required by the Russians. Kosianenko to Malik. The Brazilians keep it alive, but it's put away by Shliakovaya. And Russia have a 2-0 lead. But the bigger picture is far more worrying for Zeroberto here. 2-0. Should Russia win one of the next two sets, Brazil are almost definitely not going to make it through to the semi-finals. And coming into this tournament, that would have been inconceivable. Shliakovaya with the vital touch. 25-20 the score. Russia 2-0. And one set away from scoring a huge victory. Well, the Brazilians have been in control at the first technical timeout in both sets. 8-5 up in the first, 8-4 up in the second. They've also been in a very strong position late on in the set. Statistically, they've served three more aces than the Russians. They've blocked twice more, but they've committed one more error, and the Russians attacking far more effectively than the Brazilians. 41-30 as things currently stand. As a consequence, I say statistics don't lie. Well, they don't on the scoreboard. Russia leading 2-0. Let's take a look back at the best highlights of set number two. Back out onto court, the Russian team ready to try and put the seal on what will be the biggest win of the majority of these players' careers. Double Olympic champions, defending Montreux champions, multiple winners of the World Grand Prix, multiple winners of the World League. The Brazilian women have set the benchmark in the sport for the last 5 years. They're 2-0 down. Natalia underneath it, set by Dani Lin. Sadanetsia blocked out. Taken down by Sherban. Malik, and she's having an immense game so far. That serve taken down by Natalia. Set back to Tandara to go through the middle, and she's over the attack line. And now the Brazilians committing uncharacteristic, unforced errors. Another good serve in at Natalia. She's on the return and she finds the angle. Dani Lins. Just skipped off the top of the net. Maliver with the pump set. Camilla Bright scrambles across to keep that alive. There's a collision in the middle between the Brazilian players. Malik again. Well, any questions about this 20-year-old's temperament on the big stage have been answered so far this evening. Having a huge game, Natalia Malik. Natalia, it's an ace serve. Malik serve through the middle. And the block's good. Shliakovaya's there. 5-2. Say Roberto. Think about pressing the panic button in a minute. Timeout taken by Brazil. They trail 2-5 in set number three.
Ela só está posicionada na carota. Ou essa tem que inverter ou sobreposta. Para a primeira, para ela está na mão para chuva. O Fácil jogou para frente, ela não teve trabalho nenhum. Ela você tem que fazer ela correr. Se quiser ela deslocar, parada, ela é complicada.
Vai, 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 vai. Bora, moçada. Jane, Jane.
Really well-placed serve, and then Shliakovaya in position for the block down the middle. Malik, again, in a Gabby. Natalia's in some pressure there. Sends across a decent-looking set for Natalia, but another chance here. Kosyanenko flat to... Well, no touch is the decision. Kachakova looks disappointed with the outcome there. It was another half chance for the Russians. They have been guilty of not taking all of their opportunities. Natalia. Kuchikova is underneath it. Maliver with the bump set back to her. Kuchikova. Camilla Bright takes down. Gabby. On the line. Two in a row for the Brazilians, and suddenly they're back to within one again. Natalia pushed in on Kuchikova again. Maliver finds Kuchikova, kept alive by Malik. Kuchikova, good pressure on Gabby. She'll get another go. And the block's just wide, 3 points in a row. After the Brazilian took the timeout, and they're back on level terms again. There's no such thing as an easy set between these two. Flat serve. Kuchikova with a better return, but Shliakovaya unable to time her jump. Camilla Bright sets well to Tandara, and she just manages to get it into the block again. 4 points in a row now. And Yuri Marichev will have to think about the possibility of taking a timeout. Which he does. Vital, vital moment here. Yuri Marichev will know that should the Brazilians get any form of momentum here, he could well see them in good enough stead to see them through to the end. Natalia, and it's a foul serve, so timeout does its job. Kuchikova in to serve. Deep Natalia, not with a great reception. Kandara sees her spike taken care of, but Malik with a rare error into the net. Wasn't the best of sets. Kosyaninko to Malik. All square at seven apiece. Shlikovaya on serve. That's long. So, first technical timeout. Brazil go in leading again, although not as convincingly as they have been leading at the first technical in either of the two previous sets. It hasn't stood them in good stead leading at this stage in the previous two. What will it mean in set number three? 8-7 to the Brazilians.
Ah, é o que a gente precisa um pouquinho mais de atenção, Nath. O saque alto, não é o saque. Outra coisa, no saque da 17, pode subir e deixar a Camila passar. Passa em duas. Saque no meio, Gabriel, só combina quem vai chegar. Vamos tirar a referência um pouquinho. Na dúvida, corredor.
Russian celebrating. Point goes the way of Brazil. 9-7 now. Malik puts it long. 3-point lead now for Brazil. To the far side, Shervan, and the Russians make sure that the Brazilians don't get more than a 2-point advantage at this stage. Valencia waited for it, Gabby, a bit of luck. That the Brazilians have perhaps been lacking up until this point in the match. Taken down by Kuchinova, and then Sedaban gets the hit off the block. A serve. Brings it back to one. Danny Lintz, half blocked. Malibu's there. Kosianenko can set it back across to Kochakova, and she gracefully drops it into court. Three in a row for the Russians, and they fight back yet again. And it is 11 points apiece. Underneath it, Danny Lintz sets for through the middle for Tandara. Great effort, bump set for Kosianenko. They can only play it into court. Tandara could be there again, Adonetsia is. And turnover brilliantly by Zarezhko. 4 points now in a row, and the Russians turn it round again. Zé Roberto going mad on the sidelines. Fantastic run on the Yana Sheraban serve. Natalia into Danny Lintz again. Tandara. And she's in court. No, she hasn't. Touch of the net from the Russians. Adonetsia, taken down by Sheraban. Zarezhko, frustrated there as she commits the error. 2 points in a row, Brazil, nose in front. Adonetsia in at Sheraban again. Reverse set for Malik. That block's good. Hit off the block. Kochakova restores parity at 13 points apiece. Irina Zarezhko on serve. It's another great reception. Block back into Carroll, though. Novik and Fetisova make their way up the bench. Dipping serve. Brilliantly dealt with by Danny Lintz. Touched over by Tandara. Here's the chance, though. Kosyakova across. It'll be another point to the Russians. 15-13, they always seem to come good at this point in the set. They've led 16-13 at the second technical timeout in sets one and two. They now have the chance, if they take this point, to do it in set three as well. Zarezhko serving at Natalia. Set back to Natalia, and the block is good from Shliakovaya. Three sets in a row, they have trailed at the first technical. Three sets in a row, they have led by 3 points at the second. Two sets in a row, they've won them. It's 16-13 to the Russians. Are they about to knock the defending champions all but out of the semi-finals?
Dani, elas estão dobrando na nossa China o tempo inteiro. O passe foi ótimo para lá, se jogou para trás, e a Tandara no fundo pelo meio. Deixa a Carol pela frente, tá? Deixa a Tandara pela saída no fundo, galera.
Back out on the court, Zarezko to serve, Russia. 3 points already on the arena, Zarezko serve. Lead 16-13. Natalia again into Dani Lynch, lovely set to Tandara. Kept alive by Kosianenko. Malik, block wide. Natalia rising, ball just wide of the court. 4 points now for Zarezko on serve. Natalia, Dani Lynch has to cover some ground there. They get half a block on it. But there's no way that Shelban can keep it in. The Brazilians need a run on serve now, desperately. Dani Lynch has the ball in her hands. Taken down. Simplicity itself from Kuchikova. So the double save change, sorry, to be made here by the Russians. Kosianenko replaced by Fedosova. And Nervik coming on for Malik. Remember, as far as this group is concerned, Russia against Switzerland, the first match tomorrow. The Russians will expect to win that 3-0 or 3-1 at the very least. And if they were to do that and beat Brazil 3-0 here, it'll be Russia and China qualifying for the semi-finals. Camilla Brait doesn't get behind that. Here's a great chance, Novik sets, but pushed just wide by Shelban. What a chance that was. 18-15 instead of 19-14. And Novik and Fedosova see themselves re-replaced as Malik and her skipper Kosianenko come back on. There is the scoreline. It makes for very worrying reading for Zeroberto. Natalia on serve. They desperately need a run on her serve again. Bump set, awkward. Here's a chance, Dani Lynch and Camilla Brait can do the bump set for Tandara on that far side. Hits through and it's off the ceiling from Malava. Back to 18-16. Taken down by Kuchikova. Malik comes in. Off the block, and the Russians increase their lead to 3 points again. Six side outs required from Russia. That's all they need. However, it will seem like quite a task at the moment. On serve, Yulia Kuchikova. Dips it in, Natalia. Dani Lynch did incredibly well to keep that alive, and Tandara seizes upon it. Some outstanding play. Not a good pass. Dani Lynch's reflex is there just somehow getting them out of trouble. Carroll on serve then, 17-19. Taken down once again by Kuchikova. Malik. Brazilians have a chance. Natalia comes through the middle. Back to within one now. This is where Yuri Merichev has to think about taking his last timeout. Does he hold off? Does he take it now? Brazil still have one in the bag as well. Yuri Merichev decides to hold off. Puts his trust in his players. Chance for the Brazilians, taken by Gabby, all square at 19-all. And Yuri Maryachev storms over to his chair. Timeout is taken with the score at 19 all in set number three. Carol to serve again. So far, she's picked up 2 points on serve. It's back to 19 all. So down the line. Kuchikova was there. Shliakovaya makes sure of it. Shliakovaya to serve. 2019 the score. Taken down. Dani Lintz gets it back to Gabby. She gets the touch. Now Tandaram serve. We could do with a good run off her serve once again. They've had a couple in the match so far, most notably at the start of set number two. Shliban looks for the return. Hit off the block. And the Russians are back in front. Dani Lintz complaining there that she was taken out. Kosyanenko. Natalia into Lintz. Gabby again. The irregularity with which side-out volleyballs happened in this match means that we're almost taken by surprise when it does occur. So Roberto looks to try something new. Dani Lintz, some time to cool off. Fabiola comes in a setter. Gabriella on serve. Sherban, Kosyanenko back to Sherban. Kept alive. Here's the chance for Brazil. Fabiola sets it. Half blocked, kept alive. Could be kept in play by Malik. Camilla Paredes there. Fabiola sets again, and the block is good from Malik. Unbelievable play from the Russians. The Brazilians with the half chance to go back into the lead. The door slammed in their faces. Incredible rally, and Malik with the block. Sherban. Miller break, flings herself in. It's wide. Andrea misses, and now the Russians have the 2 point advantage again. Two side outs, all they need. Dani Lintz comes back in, Andrea comes off, as does Fabiola. Tandara also returns to the court. Zeroberto still has a timeout. And now is the time that he chooses to take it.
Vamos continuar, estamos no jogo de novo. Vai, vai, vai. Passe, atenção.
Shadaban serving again. Drops it in, Natalia underneath it. Danny Lid sets back to Natalia. The block's going to take it wide. Quite a time to be introduced into this match. Jackie comes on and she will serve straight away. Zé Roberto looking for his skipper to buy some points for him. Taken down by Shadaban, set across to the far side, and the block is good. And the Brazilians are back on level terms at 23 points apiece. Once again, down to these two sets of players to tough it out. Shadaban, Kosnianenko, Malik, and the block's good again. And Brazil have set point. Shadaban, Kosnianenko, Malik. Kosnianenko sets it across, hit off the block. And we're all square once more. So Anastasia Babikina comes on to replace Irina Zarashko. Serving to try and get the edge back for the Russians. Natalia hits through the block, Babikina keeps it alive, bump set, Malik, and Russia have match point. Celebrations from Kosnianenko. Will there be further celebrations in a moment? Gabby's underneath it. Danny Lintz sets across to Tantaru, just touches it. There's a chance here for the Russians. Kosnianenko just stays in. Kosnianenko shall set again. Brilliant defence from the Brazilians. Camilla Bray gets it across. Another chance for the Russians. Reverse set for Malik. Kosnianenko goes to Malik again. Braid keeps it alive. Gabby will put it back into play. Malik, Kosnianenko, Malik for the final time. Fails to get it away. Tandara sets. Natalia, she manages to make the court. And it is all square at 25 apiece. Thrilling, thrilling play. The Russians had their chances, failed to take them. And Brazil save a match point. Well, Malik, when she caught the top of the net, you just thought that was the opportunity gone, and Natalia manages to come good. Danny Lins to serve, the Russians looking to side out again. Kuchikova, and Kuchikova again, Malava underneath it. Brazilian block working a lot better. Kuchikova rolls it in, Camilla Bright's there, here's the chance. Danny Lins sets to Natalia, kept in play. Double touch from Malik. Pushed over, in fact, was the decision from the referee. So Brazil have a second set point. Simply done. Shliakovaya brings it back to 26 apiece. Natalia Malik on serve. Gabby, Dani Lins. Another chance for the Brazilians. Set point three. And it is Natalia on serve. Malik. Kuchikova. The chance for Brazil. Gabby. There it is. Brazil have the set. They've survived the match point. They take it into a fourth. 28 points to 26. And the thriller continues. Well, the Brazilians were down and out. 23-21. The Russians led. They managed to get 3 points in a row to bring it back to 24-23. That was their first set point. Russia won the next two to get their first match point, and on match point failed to convert. In spite of numerous chances, the Brazilians held their cool. They didn't convert set point two, they did convert set point three. And all of that means that we are headed into a fourth set here. Now, Yuri Marichev really will earn his wage now, because he has somehow got to pick his team up from the disappointment of blowing that opportunity. An immense match so far. Certainly hasn't been better at the tournament this year. Statistically, so little between them. A few more errors from the Russians, but they've also made more attacks. Well, it was an epic set, certainly worth sitting back and taking a look once again at the best highlights of it. We'll be right back.
Zorina Fetisova en place numéro 4, Irina Zarniasko.
So the perfect start for the Brazilians. Krejčíková breaks underneath it. Dani Lintz with another chance here. Natalia. Yuri Marichev. Distraught. Shalaban again. Breit keeps it alive. Natalia goes down the line. Kosienko. Malik tried to just guide that one past Dani Lintz. Lintz responded. Tandara's there. Shalaban again. Kosienko. And this time the Russians have the point. Fedosova to serve, taken down by Gabby, set by Dani Lintz to the far side, and Natalia's blocked back into herself. Fedosova, Gabby with the takedown, Dani Lintz, Tandara finds that cross-court angle. So Adonetsia to serve. Well, it's a rare foul serve. Both teams have served at the highest level and made the opposition play, but on that occasion Adonetsia just strays long. Natalia Malik serving at Natalia once again. Dani Lintz, Tandara has to push it in. Kosienko, Shalaban, bump set. Triple block was there, and there was no way through for Krejčíková. Dani Lintz serves, taken down by Krejčíková. Just out of the reach on that occasion. Krejčíková will now serve. Ace, so all square.
Et cette année, ils sont la Russie.
Camilla Breit electing to leave it. It was well in. Natalia, Dani Lintz sets across to Tandara. Russian blocks there this time. 6-5 the score. Krejčíková dips one in, Natalia gets it and then responds with the spike, which is half block. Malava. Shalaban, this time she's blocked. Brings it to 6 points all. Natalia. Set, just touched over. Camilla Breit keeps it alive. Dani Lintz sends to Tandara. The block's good. The Brazilians keep it alive. Good footwork from Gabby. But then the cross-court spike comes from Shliakovaya. And the Russians back into the lead. Kavaya now serves in at Camilla Brate. Danny Lintz with the perfect pass to her and Gabby. It's a huge block. Natalia bump sets it for Tandara, touched over. Shlyakovaya underneath that one. Kosyanenko and through the middle. And the Russians have a 2-point lead at the first technical. First time that they've managed that in the match. It's 8 points to 6.
Aquela posição que a levantadora está lá, que é a nossa posição 1, tem que fazer a Carol mais seca no tempo, ou tempo atrás, para soltar a Tandara em cima dela lá. Nós não podemos perder ponto com a levantadora na rede. E ela está na rede agora! Tá? Mantém pela frente, solta lá.
Sankins, 8-6 the lead for Russia. Shlyakovaya to serve. Taken down by Natalia. Danny Lynn sits to that far side for Gabby, who hits through the block this time. Carol. Taken down by Kochakova. Sheraban just misses the ceiling. It's a bit of luck there for the Brazilians. Gabby kept alive. Malik can't get it over the net. And Brazil back on level terms once more. Carol serves, much better serve, Sheraban underneath that one, comes the return, half blocked, flung in, there goes Carol, Gabby was there, Maliba manages to keep it alive and somehow gets it back out of the net, Danny Lintz back to Gabby, kept alive again from the back line, unbelievable rally this one, Lintz across to Gabby for the third time and she falls away, and the Russians take the point. Good serve comes in from Kosyanenko and Danny Lintz gets it to Tandara. Maliba takes down, set across to Malik. Good block from Adonitsia. And it's all square at 9-all. Tandara serves into Maliba. Gets a touch from Sheraban. Sheraban serve. Natalia. Malova sets a counter. Malik, great block from the Brazilians to square it up at 10 apiece. Bevakina comes on for Malik. This gives her a few moments to cool off. And the serve will be taken by Gabby. Nicely put away by Fedosova. And she will now serve at 11-all. Dani Lin sets to the far side. Natalia, great readjustment in midair to use the one hand to just guide it home. Venezia. Once again, Zeroberto's arms go up. Bevakina, Dani Lins. Bevakina keeps it alive. Brazilians will have to win the point again. Daniel into the far side. Natalia does so. Daniel Lynch serves. Taken down. Not particularly well by Kuchikova. Fed back inside. Tandara gets the return and she hits off the block and it opens up a 2-point lead for the Brazilians. A serve from Dani Lins and it moves out. 3-point advantage now, and another change to be made by the Russians. Markova comes on. Well, Kuchikova and Malik both in certain strife on the sidelines, both exhausted. And now, potentially, it's just a question of keeping them alive for what could be a deciding breaker. Momentum is not with the Russians, though. Dani Lins, beautifully put away by Tandara. At the moment, it's becoming too easy for the Brazilians. They lead 16-13 at the second technical timeout. In the previous three, it's been the same margin, but in Russia's favour. And so the Brazilians in a strong position here at the moment to take it through into a breaker. And if they were to do that, that would potentially end, or would end, Russia's hopes of competing in the semi-finals. It would give the Brazilians the point they need to secure a semi-final berth. Well, you definitely can't question the Russian effort out there. But the Brazilians just... have managed to claw their way back in here. And the exhaustion of those Russian players in the end could come to play its own part in this match. They gave absolutely everything. They've had a match point, remember. Wide from Natalia. Second foul on serve that the Brazilians have had in this set. Just the ball straight back to the Russians. Shlyakovaya. Natalia takes down well. Danny Lin sets across and Gabby goes long. No touch. Kavaya again, in at Natalia. Good takedown. Gabby hits off the block. Need some pressure here. Shalaban. Camilla Brake gets underneath it. Danny Lintz with the chance. Touched over beautifully by Gabby. Spotted the air. Such a big gap. Reinstates that two-point lead. Serve. And an ace. Timeout taken by Russia. It's the first of this set. And the Brazilians lead by 18 points to 15. Brenda Castillo, the Dominican Republic. Libero standing in the wings here, just watching on. Dominican Republic will be in action in our final match of the day. We'll get underway half an hour after the end of this one, which at present looks as though it is going to go the distance. Set to this near side, where Sherban rolls it home. Danny Lintz sets across and hit off the block by Tandara, but she goes down in real pain. Well, everyone off the Brazilian bench here. Tandara comes down. And collides there, like anything deliberate from Shalaban there. But Tandara landed on the foot here of Shalaban, who was right on the line. And it means that Tandara looks as though she's going to play no further part. Real pain down on the sidelines. One hopes that it is not too serious. Monique, the player to replace her.
C'est bien entendu pas la passe. C'est bien entendu pas la passe. Danny Lins qui se fait mal, mais bien la numéro 11, Tandara Keseta.
So Monique joins the fray and immediately will have to serve at a pretty crucial juncture as well. Brazil leading 19-16. Deep, taken down well, touched over, Dani Lins keeps it alive, Camilla Brait sets it to Monique, her first touch, and she gets the point. Now, impossible scenarios that can pan out here, of course, if the Brazilians come back to two sets apiece, it will mean, as we take another Russian timeout, with the margin of 4 points apart, the Russians still can qualify for the semi-finals if they win. But they have to win this match. All momentum is currently with Brazil, of course. Monique to serve again then. Sent to Babakina. Camilla Brait keeps it alive. Dani Lins sets back to Gabby. Triple block goes wide. Brilliant stay on track to take this one into a decider. Monique again. Decent serve. Hevkina, the block's there from Adonetsia, it wasn't a good enough pass. 4 points in a row, and the Brazilians 3 points away from taking this into the breaker. A match point in set three at 25-24. Looks as though it will come back to haunt the Russians. Foul serve. Natalia, brilliant takedown from Malova, and Natalia over the line as well. Now, Brazil do have both team timeouts still in the bag, so they won't be too concerned at this stage. Still have a 4 point advantage, and Zeliberto decides that now is the time to take the first of those timeouts just to cool everyone off a little. Shalaban to serve, 18-22. Taken down by Natalia. Just kept alive at the net there. Set back across, Gabby block wide. And then the Brazilians break that run. Set, serve. Looked as though it was just ducking in. So the Russians keep it in play. Danny Lintz able to send to the far side when Natalia touches over. Kamila Brake keeps it alive. Danny Lintz goes for it. And Natalia across the line. Decision from the chair is the point goes the way of the Russians. Decision agreed from the near side, and Zeliberto has to swallow a bit of humble pie. And Anetsia makes it set point now. To take us into a breaker. Change mate, Fabiola comes on. Andrea on as well, and it'll be Fabiola to serve. Pavlikina, kept alive by Gabby quite brilliantly. Malova sets again, and Marakova manages to save the first of those set points. Set point number two, though. Fabiola sets to the far side, Natalia. There it is, Brazil take us into a breaker. Points to 20. Another fantastic effort from the Brazilians. Yesterday they had to come back from 2-1 down to beat China. Today they've had to come back from 2-0 down. They still haven't won this one. They have all the momentum, though. Having taken sets three and set number four, they've saved a match point. And the two skippers have the flip of the coin. And the two teams will change ends. There is practically nothing between them after those four sets. And that is reflected in the scores that we've seen. 35-33 in the opening set, 25-20 to the Russians in the second. The Brazilians have taken the fourth by the same margin, and they won set number three, 28-26. It has been, thus far, an epic encounter, and we're still not done. two teams back out on court. 0-0, first to 15, two timeouts. A change of ends when one team reaches eight. It will be Jana Shadoban to serve first. Natalia comes back in, half blocked, but it's good enough for the Brazilian to take the opening point. Dani Lin's serve, taken down by Shadoban. Kosyanenko. And that has gone long with no touch. Disastrous start for Kuchikova. Perfectly lined up for her, just needed to hit it through the block. Advantage Brazil already. Dani Lins again. Malik back into the fray, manages to get her first point. Brings Zeleshko. Monique blocked, Breit is underneath it. Communication needed for the Brazilians. And here is the chance for Russia to get back on level terms. Kosyanenko across and down the line. Back onto level terms. Kuchikova finds her mark this time. Monique hits through the block. Malik, the block comes good for Brazil. Russians need to be more inventive in attack. Carol with the decisive touch. Natalia's serve again, taken down by Kuchikova. Malik with an ace, and we're back on level terms once more. Will that give her a much needed lift? Natalia Malik, exhausted in set number four, came off for the tail end of it. She's back and responds with a good ace there. Natalia, too much on that. Kosyanenko. Chances for both teams. The block from Brazil from Monique. And they escape unpunished. The top of the ceiling after the touch from Shliakovaya. Well, you wouldn't want it any other way in this breakup. The two have matched each other toe for toe throughout the entire match. wouldn't want one of them to suddenly run away with it in this tiebreaker. Serve from Kuchikova to the near side for Gabby. The Brazilians do have the edge though. The lead 6-5. Sherdaban, it clips her heel on the way through, and Brazil have a two-point advantage once again. The incredible nature of the character shown by the Brazilians. They had an equally tough encounter against Russia during the Olympic Games in 2012 in the quarterfinals, which could have seen them out, survived three match points in that one. Put home by Shlikovaya. Gabby blocked, and the Russians fight back to level terms. Natalia. Gabby this time finds a mark, so at the change of ends, Brazil still with a slender advantage, but it's only the single point, 8-7. Remain on the edge of their seats. They have been royally entertained. Taken down by Sherdaban. Kosyanenko. And Sadashko uses all of her 1.96 meters, reach of 3.05 meters, to bring it back to 8 points apiece. Kosyanenko on serve. Natalia straight into the path of Sarajko, and the Russians go back in front. Still no timeouts used by either coach. Camilla Breit, Dani Lintz to Monique. She's brilliantly blocked. And it's a two-point advantage, and surely now Zieroberto will have to use up his first timeout, or will he instead just make a couple of changes? That seems to be what he's decided to do. Andrea and Fabiola coming into the fray. Good takedown, but Natalia's blocked. Once again, it's Sarajko who manages to make the block. 3 points the difference. Timeout Brazil. Russia leading 11-8. Well, it will leave things fascinatingly poised in this pool, because if the Russians do manage to win against Switzerland tomorrow in that opening game by 3-0, as the Brazilians have done, as the Chinese have done, it will mean that all of the top teams perhaps one, two. Lost one, and they will have all lost that one game in a breaker. And it will come down, I'm sure, to just points scored. As a consequence, well, I'll let you do the maths on that. Donashko with that latest block. A good run here of 4 points in a row for the Russians. They've won six of the last seven. Kosianenko on serve again. Gabby, the touchdown to Adonitsia. Kept alive. Played in by Kuchikova. Paredes underneath it. Wasn't ideal. It's a set from Fabiola. Adonitsia tries to turn it over on two. Touched over. Malova, another great chance here. Kosianenko sets again. Shelovan. 12-8 now to the Russians. They're just 3 points away from scoring victory. A victory they thought they already had. Danny Lintz and Monique come back in. Well, all of that momentum had gone the way of Brazil, and now firmly rests in the Russians' court. Kosianenko drops it in. Gabby. Malova keeps it alive. Kosianenko sets back to Shelovan. Monique. Touch from Gabby. Camilla Parekh's only going to be able to play that into court. Malova underneath it. Kosianenko sets again. Shelovan. Camilla Parekh can't get to that. The Russians now just two away. Brazil take their second timeout with this match slipping away. 13 points to 8, Russia lead.
De novo, galera, vamos lá, 13 a 8. Nós já saímos de nossa área, vamos embora de novo. Vai, vamos embora, Nando.
Russia on the brink. Now the Brazilians have come back from the brink once before. Are they able to do so again? Some of those fans praying that they can. If Russia are to win, it'll be this run on the Kosianenko serve that wins it for them. Gabby underneath it. Set and Adonitsia unable to bowl that one in. Kosianenko sets it back to Shelovan. Tried to be too cute. Jackie comes on to replace Adonitsia. Now, she has been on before and served them out of trouble. That was at the end of set. Number three, when they trailed 21-23. Taken down by Shelovan. Side out needed by the Russians. Brilliant get from Jackie to keep this point alive. Natalia Kosianenko. Malova with the bump set. Shelovan. No touch. Yuri Malichev has two timeouts. He takes his first one now. As the tension continues to mount. The good work in that rally coming from Jackie. She serves again, 10-13. taken down by Shadaban. Bump set. Rolled in. And now the Russians have match point. They've already had one at the end of the third set, but they have four of them this time. And surely they will feel that they can convert one of those. Match point number two for Russia with Shadaban on serve. Taken down by Gabby. Danny Lin sets across to Natalia. There's one save. So Danny Lin serves, needing to save a further three. Taken down by Shadaban. Kosyaninko sets to the near side to Kuchikova. Malova has to get it back to Kuchikova for a second time. Camilla breaks to Natalia. Malova behind that one. Kosyaninko across to Kuchikova again. And this time the Russians have the victory. They take it by 3-2 in the breaker. A thrilling match finally concluded. 15 points to 11. Kuchikova with the winning spike. A sensational match that really has lit up the Montreux Volley Masters 2014. It means that at present, the Brazilians pick up a point to put them level on six with China, who played all of their games. The Russians still have their last match in Pool A to come up against Switzerland. And they will be hoping that they can win that one by 3-0. And then it'll come down to a question of points scored. That, well, depends entirely on that match between Russia and Switzerland. They will have to be clinical, and if they are, they will stand every chance. Kuchikova with the vital kill in the end. And Russia taking victory after an enthralling 5-set match here. Well, nobody really deserved to be a loser from that encounter. But in the end, it's the Russians who come out on top. 35-33, 25-20, 26-28, 20-25, 15-11.